all like her spending our time being good. How could she make any money from that?
Maybe she owns a piece of vision cap.
Hey, Benny Soundstream.
The horse, how you doing? You know Madison Nicely Johnson.
Yeah, how goes it?
Nicely, thank you. Tell me, guys, what about Nathan and Troy? Does he got a place for his crap game?
We don't know yet.
The heat is on. He's still looking for a place.
Well, tell him I'm loaded and looking for action.
I just acquired 5 G's.
$5,000.
Where'd you acquire that?
I collected the reward on my father.
Everyone's looking for action. I wish them.
Mr. Southstreet, this is Lieutenant Brannigan from the New York Police Department.
Oh, pleasure.
Any of you guys seen Nathan DeJoy?
Which Nathan DeJoy is that?
I mean the Nathan DeJoy who's been running a crap game around here. Getting away with it by moving it to a different spot each night.
Why are you telling us this, Your Honor?
Because I know you two bums. You work for Detroit.
Customers
for his crap game.
We do?
Yeah. You can tell him from me that I know right now he's running around looking for a spot. Well, he's not going to find that spot. Because everybody knows Brady is going to get out of the
next. Honey, I'm in a terrible trouble. Everybody's scared I'll get out of that lousy brain. Well, I can't. Oh, hello, Lieutenant. I trust you do not think I was talking about you.
There are other lousy brains. Detroit, I was just talking to your colleagues about your crap game. I'd imagine you're having trouble finding a place.
Well, the heat is on, but you must know from the fact that you now have to live on your salary.
Find a place?
What does that cop want from me? What am I? A sex maniac? No. I merely run a crap game for the convenience of those who want a little action, in return for which I take a small cut. Is that a crime?
Yeah. Nathan, did you find a place?
Did you find a place for the game?
Did I find a place?
Did I?
Yes,
I found a place. We're having the game tomorrow night at the Radio City Music Hall.
I ain't gonna fix the issues.
I tried all the regular places. The back of the cigar shop, the funeral parlor.
Nathan, you said something about the Biltmore Garage.
I checked the Biltmore Garage. Spoke to Joey Biltmore himself. He said he might take a chance on letting me use the place if I give him $1,000.
$1,000?
In cash. You won't even take my marker.
Marker's no good, huh?
What do you mean? A marker ain't just a piece of paper that says, I owe you $1,000. Signed Nathan Detroit. It's like a pledge, a guy can't welch on. It's like not saluting the flag.
Well, my mark is as good as gold. Only Joey Biltmore don't think so.
You know, it don't seem possible. Me without a livelihood. Well, I've been running this crap game ever since I was a juvenile delinquent.
Hey, can't you do something?
What can I do? I'm broke. I couldn't even buy Adelaide a present today.
You know what day today is? It's me and Adelaide's 14th anniversary.
Yeah?
Yep, we've been engaged for 14 years.
I know, I can make a fortune. But where can I have the game?
And they've now got a lock on the door.
them around the crack game again so he'll never set foot on it again.
Hey, let me get you.
Adelaide, can't you?
You go ahead, girl. I ordered you two to see if I'm right. And it's time for Sunday. We can make a catch up with mayonnaise. Yeah, exactly. We gotta get back with the hot dog.
Are you still rehearsing?
Yeah. That's later, Charlie. You've been watching us all day. So finally I said, look, Charlie, I'm full of this. I gotta get out of here and get something to eat. And he said, well, you just want to sneak out of here and eat that cheap bum named Detroit.
So what'd you tell him?
Well, I told him. I said I can go meet whoever I want.
Well, don't upset yourself. How's your cold?
Oh, it's much better, thank you. Nathan, have you any present for me?
A present? For me?
Oh, I hope you like it.
Wow, a belt!
Read the card.
Sugar is sweet, and so is jelly. So put this belt around your belt. Adelaide, that's so sweet. Look, honey, about your present, why don't I get you a diamond wristwatch with a gold band and two rubies on the side?
Oh, Nathan, you shouldn't have.
It's all right. I didn't. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. I kind of like it when you forget to give me presents. It makes me feel like we're married.
It'll be all right. One of these days I'll be in money, and you'll have more mink than a mink.
Oh, Nathan, I can do without anything, just so long as you don't go about running the crap game again.
The crap game? What an absurd thought.
$1,200 cheesecake and $1,500 strudel.
What?
Yesterday, Mindy sold $1,200 cheesecake and $1,500 strudel.
More strudel than cheesecake? Great.
Hey, Bill, what is it?
Nothing, honey. Nothing.
Hey, any news yet?
Not yet, Harry. I'll let you know.
All right, Joy.
What was that all about?
He was right ahead of the baby.
So why is he asking you?
He's nervous. It's his first wife. Now look, I'm expecting a fella, and I know you're about to start.
Are you trying to get rid of me?
No, I don't want your sandwich to get soft. Fellas, why don't you take Adelaide over to the drugstore? You see, honey, it's across the street, and you've got a cold, and there's a lot of open manholes around.
Oh, Nathan, you're so thoughtful. Why did you get the sweetest poison? Goodbye!
Well, Sky Matters, I'm glad to see you, Sky.
Nathan, your promoter, you.
How's everything going? You look great.
I feel great. 2 weeks out west of Nevada, great place. Beautiful scenery, helpful climate, and I've been here for 50 G's of blackjack.
50 G's? You going to be in town long?
Nah, I'm flying to Havana tomorrow.
Havana?
What's that action down there? You want to go with me?
Nah, I got a lot of things to do. Meantime, what about dropping in the menu for a piece of cheesecake?
Maybe sell a lot of cheesecake. No, I'm not hungry. So tell me how's that like?
Ashley's fine. Still dancing at Hot Box.
I suppose one of these days she'll be getting married.
Well, we all got to go sometime.
But Nathan, we can play it. Guys like us, Nathan, we got to remember that as pleasant as a doll's company may be, she must always take second place to aces back to back.
Yeah, yeah. So tell me, Hurry, how about dropping in the minutes for a piece of cheesecake or a strudel or something?
No, I think I'll go get the little ball.
Oh, well, you will have to admit that Mindy sells the best cheesecake in the country.
Yes, I'm quite caught up with Mindy's cheesecake.
Who ain't?
Although,
there are those who like Mindy's strudel. Oh, Dan, what did you say Mindy sold more of yesterday? Cheesecake or strudel?
Well, I never give much thought. But if everybody's like I am, I'd say Mindy sells much more cheesecake than strudel.
For how much?
Huh?
For how much?
Well, Nathan, I never knew you was a betting man. You always take your percentage right off the top.
Well, for old time's sake, I thought I'd just give you a little action. I will bet you $1,000 that yesterday Mindy sold more strudel than cheesecake.
Nathan, let me tell you a little story.
No.
When I was a young man, about to go into the world, my father said to me a very valuable thing. Son, the old guy says, I'm very sorry that I'm not able to bankroll you with a very large sum. But not having any potatoes to give you, I'm now going to send you some very valuable advice. One of these days in your travels, you'll come across a man who'll show you a nice brand new deck of cards on which the seal has not yet been broken. This man will then offer to bet you that he can make the jack of spades jump up out of the deck and squirt cider in your ear. But son, do not bet this man, for as sure as you're standing there, you'll end up with an ear full of cider. Now, Nathan, I do not
in what business in.
Fine, old gentleman. I suppose he sort of looks after you.
We look after each other.
I suppose whenever one of you goes, the other goes as well?
Yes, of course.
Well, of course.
Here are two papers I'd like you to read. They will give you a good deal of comfort.
Thank you.
And we're having a special prayer meeting on Thursday, which I'm sure you wish to attend.
I'm sure. Miss Sarah, I hope you don't think I'm getting out of line, but I think it's just wonderful to see a pretty doll, a nice-looking lady like yourself, sacrificing herself for the sake of others. Staying here all the time, do you ever go anywhere, travel or anything?
I would like to go to Africa.
Oh, that's just a little far, but there are a lot of wonderful places just a few hours from New York by plane. Have you ever been on a plane?
No.
Oh, it's wonderful.
Here's another picture I'd like to read.
Thank you. Of course, I'll need a lot of personal.
I'll be speaking at the Thursday prayer meeting.
I mean, well, maybe we could have dinner or something?
I think not, Mr. Madison.
Sorry, just lost me under the north of your kindness. Hey, that's wrong.
What's wrong?
It's not Proverbs, it's Isaiah.
It's Proverbs.
Sorry. No peace unto the wicked. Isaiah chapter 57, verse 22.
Isaiah?
There are two things that have been in every literature in the country, Scott Matheson and the Gideon Bible. Why, I must have read the good book 10 or 12 times.
You read the Bible 12 times?
What's the matter with the Bible? Besides, in my line of work, the strangest information frequently comes in handy. Why, I once won 5 G's on the parlay, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Tell me, Mr. Matheson, why are we here?
Oh, I told you, I'm a sinner.
You're lying.
Well, lying's a sin. Look, I'm a big sinner. And give me a date to five, the others will follow. You need sinners, don't you?
We're managing.
Let's be honest, this place is laying an egg. I bet I can fill this place with sinners.
I don't bet.
Well, how about if I make you a small proposition? When's this meeting here? It's Thursday? I will guarantee you 1 dozen genuine sinners. I'll also guarantee you that they will sit and listen to what you have to say. Your end of the bargain is to have dinner with me.
Why did you want to have dinner with me?
Because I'm hungry. Here.
What's this?
Scott Matheson's marker for 12 cents. You don't think it's good? Ask anyone in town. I owe you 1 dozen genuine cents. I'll pick up at noon tomorrow, then.
At noon?
Well, it'll take us a little time to get where we're going.
To get where?
My favorite restaurant.
Well, where's that?
El Cafe Cubana, in Havana.
El Cafe Havana?
Well, where do you want to eat? Howard Johnson's?
I now realize, Mr. Gamble, that when you were describing the blackness of your heart, you didn't do yourself justice.
Well, and I now realize, Sister Sarah, that no matter how beautiful a sergeant may be, she is still a sergeant.
Oh, please go away.
Why don't you change your pitch, Sarge? Come, one and all, to the Save a Soul mission. Except guys. I hate guys.
Well, I don't hate anybody.
Except me? I'm relieved to know that it's just me personally, and not all guys in general. It is nice to know that there's a man somewhere
Thank you.